The British Isles boast some of the world's finest stately homes, magnificent monuments of a bygone era. But behind these stunning facades lurks a dirty secret.
If I don't do something, it's going to get to a point of no return.
It's in a right old state and needs a right bloody good clean.
Possibly got a bit out of hand, shall we say.
But there is a radical solution.
I like to hoover the air. For me, that's a peace of mind that I'm getting rid of a lot of particles.
Now the nation's most obsessive cleaners are back to restore order to the country house clutter.
Order means control. Disorder means chaos.
Pairing up to face the grandest grime of their lives.
There's poo everywhere.
And to challenge their obsessions, they'll be moving in.
Oh my God, that's where someone's bum's been.
The way I'm feeling at the moment, I don't want to stay here.
Right.
The compulsive cleaners have just 5 days to clean up these rotting rooms.
He's a dirty pig.
I think she's being a little bit fussy.
Can they change the fortunes of these mouldy mansions?
Oh, my God, look at the bottom of that toilet, for God's sake.
Or have they finally met their match?
This is where they butcher people!
There's only one boss in this house, and that's me.
Hidden away on the northeast coast of Scotland is the Gind. The site of this Regency mansion has been in the same family for nearly 4 centuries. The current custodian, 78-year-old John Octoloni, grew up here and took over the 400-acre estate from his father.
It's almost like a little kingdom, really. but not always very easy.
The house may be steeped in a rich family history, but under John's reign, it's been in steady decline.
Gind is pretty untidy at the minute. Possibly got a bit out of hand, shall we say. I don't collect anything, actually, but I don't throw away much stuff either, so things tend to accumulate.
Since separating from his wife 20 years ago, retired engineer John lives alone.
What am I doing next? We're going to do chainsaws.
Surrounded by DIY projects, which rarely get finished.
About 2 years, it's been work in progress. But come a few months' time, it'll be converted into a comfortable bathroom.
John was always a hoarder, and is more so as he gets older. I think very few things are ever thrown away, basically. It would take a lot of work to get this house up to snuff.
You could spend an awful lot of time tidying. To what purpose, I don't know.
As the Gind falls further into disrepair, for the first time, its survival for future generations is in doubt.
There's no point pushing on with the Gind as it is and everything if this son and heir isn't interested in it.
John's son and heir, Elliot, grew up on the estate. Now aged 23, he lives and studies in New York. But he's due to return in 5 days for his twice-yearly visit to the Gind.
Hello, Elliot. You're coming on Saturday. Is it Saturday?
I'm leaving on Friday, and I'm coming there on Saturday.
Lunchtime, I think, is the idea. So look forward to that.
Now John is looking to hand over the reins. But Elliot is under no illusions about the pitfalls of running a country estate.
I think about taking over the Gind all the time, but I definitely recognise that it would be a load of work. I changed my mind a lot about whether or not I would want to inherit it.
Well, it's rather crucial, really. If Elliot wouldn't say, no, I'm not interested, it could be a disaster. Once it's gone, it's gone.
It's really important that the Gind remains in the family. I think it would be a travesty if it gets sold, made into a hotel or whatever.
In a bid to win Elliot over, John is planning a grand ceilidh to welcome him back to his childhood home. But first, he must deal with the decades of dust and debris.
There is a certain desperation, I suppose, to get the place tidied up because Elliot comes back in a week. But I do need assistance with it because I think I'm not quite good at it on my own, you see.
500 miles away in Sussex could be the answer to John's prayers.
When I clean my table, I do circular motions because I feel like it's getting more of the germs, whereas one swipe, it's not sufficient enough for me. I like a circle.
31-year-old Hayley often cleans her house for up to 19 hours a day.
My worst moment is when my husband tried to restrain me from cleaning and I threw a taster across the room at him. Like, I shouldn't have done it, but that was how bad my OCD was.
A mother of three, she sterilises her children's toys every day and she won't even go on family holidays.
I've not been away on a family holiday for 5 years. I went away before with my friends and it was like an all-inclusive and these flies kept landing on the buffet food. And you know what flies land on? Feces is what they land on. They land on poo. You literally are going to end up with, like, dunno, semolina.
With her obsessions dominating her world, Hayley is leaving her sterile home to take on her biggest ever clean.
I am massively fed up with my OCD controlling my life. So I need to get past my phobias of germs and poo and coming into contact with people that maybe aren't as sterile as I am.
Joining Hayley will be Dann from Nottingham.
I shampoo my cats like every 10 days because I'll do everything in my power to make sure that my home is as germ-free as possible.
Although not diagnosed with OCD, 25-year-old Dann spends 40 hours a week making his house show home perfect.
Painting's the ultimate clean. In the last 18 months, I've done this one about, I'm not going to lie, about 10 times I've painted.
But for Dann, a lifetime obsession has come at a heavy cost.
I have to clean this, clean that before I go out, and I can't just pick up my keys and leave. So I want to be a bit more in control.
Hoping to challenge their obsessions, Dann and Hayley have agreed to eat and sleep at John's cluttered country pile for the duration of the 5-day clean.
This is like the perfect opportunity. If I can stay in a dirty house, I literally could do anything. Because we're going to Scotland, I am packing like lots of tartan because I do like that. I am nervous, but I want to be like, I've helped someone along the way and I've also helped myself.
I will find it difficult staying away from home, but that's only because I know exactly when things were last cleaned. That's my trusty old blow-up bed, so I don't have to sleep on anybody's dirty mattress. That's what I would like to challenge, just so I can start to live a normal life.
They have tackled grimy houses before, but John's will be their most challenging clean yet.
Don't you think all posh people with big houses like live in the middle of nowhere?
Yeah, it's because they don't want to mix with commoners like us.
Mm. There's loads of sheep over there.
I didn't even see those sheep over there. I don't like sheep. When they poo, it sticks to their fur. How do people survive out here? It's like a poonami.
Ooh. Oh, it's big.
Don't like this at all. It's gonna stink in there like anus. I don't want to go in after seeing that. If that's what the outside looks like, imagine what the inside's like.
Hello.
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 Hi. Welcome to the Gind.
Thank you.
I'm John.
Hiya, Dann. And this is Hayley.
Dann.
Hello, Hayley.
Would you like to look?
Yeah, please, I'd love to.
Yeah, oh, well, go ahead.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Stop it at once.
Yeah. It's busy for an entrance hall, isn't it? What is the chainsaw for?
It'd have to have some repairs done to it. I'll do it on the kitchen table.
You don't have a cleaner then?
Not a regular cleaner, no. You have to clean up for them.
The cleaners might find the entrance hall busy, but the bathroom is on a different level altogether.
This is the bathroom.
What?
Oh, John, stop it at once. You're joking. This is more like a butcher's than a bathroom. Like, there's mallets and hacksaws.
You can't bathe anywhere.
Well, yeah, it does need a little a tidy. It might be rather nice, actually, when it's done.
And the final leg of the tour is the room where John spends most of his time.
Here's the kitchen.
Oh, no, honestly, this room, it terrifies me the most. Look at those potatoes. Look what's growing out of them.
There's a thing for sandpapering your toenails and everything.
You don't do your toenails with that, John.
Hayley discovers evidence that John's not the only person using this kitchen.
You've had a mouse on that, haven't you?
Yeah.
John, I don't know how you're still here. Mice are vermin.
Before the cleaners can get to grips with John's accumulation of filth and clutter, he wants to establish some house rules.
So, welcome to the gym once again. And these are my rules. We don't want to put any bleach down the drain. If you want to use something really ferocious, chuck it on the gravel, it will kill the weeds. I don't really want to part with anything without seeing it go. Because I really am concerned about, you know, there's a lot, as you say, lots of stuff.
You might have to just let go of some stuff.
Yeah.
So, like, say you've got, like, 5 chainsaws, it would be amazing if you could just, like, maybe get rid of one.
Yeah, we have a little place for those things to go.
OK.
As long as they've all got a place and it's not in the bathroom or the hallway.
Right, well, I think that's enough.
I have never, ever, ever seen a home like that. It's just hideous.
He's maybe lived like this for so long.
Yeah.
I reckon it's going to be a struggle for us to try and, like, get him to get rid of all of the junk that he's got.
Oh, God, we've got our work cut out.
Right, are you ready?
Let's go.
With just 5 days to transform the house in time for John's party for Elliot, Dann and Hayley need to get the clean started.
John, you've never used one of these before, have you?
The kitchen has been accumulating grime and garbage for the last 20 years.
So if you sweep it all off for me, John, like, that will make me so proud of you, because it shows you're letting go of all this clutter. Yeah?
I recognise things, you see it now and again.
So we can probably put all of this in the bin, can't we?
No, that's the end of a blind.
So is that being thrown, the end of the blind?
No. Bit of screw here, they're not bad.
These?
Hold on a minute, just take it easy on the hardware.
Oh, we can't keep getting it back out, though.
Bamboo's good, I like bamboo.
I think this has had it as well, John. I think we should throw
it. No, that's all right.
Are you joking? Look at it, John.
I know it's dirty, but it still works.
Oh, John, I just think we're keeping lots of things, aren't we?
Aren't we? Yeah, oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. We're going to keep an awful lot of stuff.
We won't throw note away, will we?
I'm getting concerned now because I'm so keen to have it looking nice for Elliot when he arrives, and it's dawning on me that that may not be the case because there's so much to get rid of.
With a 5-night stay ahead of them, Dann and Hayley want to see what accommodation John has on offer.
Here we are, the bathroom.
Oh!
Before marrying her husband of 9 years, Hayley wouldn't even stay at his house until it had been professionally cleaned.
I wouldn't even put my big toe in there.
It is a bit scummy, isn't it?
I think it's the veg oil, you see. I shave with veg oil, so it floats on the water and sticks to the sides.
I wouldn't. I just couldn't.
No. Dann, this is your room.
Due to his chronic fear of germs, Dann hasn't even stayed at a friend's house for over 10 years.
Oh, I mean, look at that. The windows are mouldy. Oh, you've got to be kidding.
There's mouse shit on the floor. Not even discreet. That's like smack bang in the middle. They didn't care when they was doing that.
This is your room.
Oh, John.
Little present for you. A bathrobe there, keep you warm. And let's hope you had a lovely night's sleep.
Night, John.
Night-night.
He wants me to put that on once I've had a wash. And what's that? Oh, my God! Look, that's where someone's bum's been. That's definitely skid marks, look. I can't wear that. I can't stay here.
Why?
Because there's just... There's poo and bugs. Look, I'm sure it's mouse poo.
I've got exactly the same in my room. There's no way on this planet I'm staying.
We better go and tell John then.
We're not going to stay tonight.
Are you?
No, there's that sort of bit of mouse droppings on the floor and stuff.
Really?
And I'm just really nervous that I'm going to end up sick in the morning.
Oh dear, that'd be serious.
See you later.
Bye, John.
They escape to the safety of a nearby hotel for the night.
Now I'm in my nice clean hotel, I'm going to give it once over because I don't trust that it is actually properly clean, and I don't know whose like bum's been in the bath.
A little bit of dirt wouldn't bother me, but maybe some people it does. Perhaps they think it's going to migrate towards them or something. I could not contemplate being that intensive on cleaning.
At the Ginn estate in the northeast of Scotland, John Ochterlony is bracing himself for the return of the cleaners.
I'm feeling slightly apprehensive about all, you know, the stuff. It's going to be a nightmare, I think.
Having stayed the night at a hotel, Hayley and Dann are coming back for their first full day of cleaning. Armed with a vital piece of kit.
It does feel me a touch of the dreads coming in there, wondering how we're going to fill it up with what.
Surprise!
Yes, I see it out there.
I was thinking we might need more skits.
Oh, you think so?
You've got an awful lot of things that
I'd
think...
I'd be very sceptical about
need
that.
..need to go.
Lots of stuff can't go, you see.
With the arrival of John's son, Elliot, the future heir, in just 4 days, the cleaners will focus on the rooms needed for his homecoming party. The grand hall. The dining room. And the kitchen.
Shall we get some boxes and start removing some stuff?
Having failed to get John to part with any possessions so far, they're going in for a second attempt at his 20-year build-up of clutter.
Are you going to keep that?
Oh, yeah, it's part of the toolkit. Sandpapering doors and things.
I mean, look, mouse has clearly been in that lot.
Well, I suppose you need something to put in the skip, don't you? It's a child's gas mask from World War II.
It's been pooed all in by the mice as well, look.
Let's shake it into the...
in the compost.
Oh, no, you've left some cream in there and it's got green mould all on it.
Are you going to wash it out or...?
You are kidding, aren't you? Smell it.
Those are recyclers when they're cleaned.
I can't, I'm going to be sick.
Oh, dear.
That's not right.
To spare Hayley's nostrils, John removes the offending cream pot to a safe distance.
Conceal, conceal, conceal.
But not as far as the skip.
Smell down there is appalling. That cream, it smells like a badger's anus. It's awful.
But the guest loo, where she's seeking refuge, is making her feel even worse.
Look at all the feces on the toilet.
Abandoning the kitchen clean, Hayley commandeers Dann to launch an attack on the loo.
I don't think I've ever come across a sink that was so dirty. Oh, God, it smells horrendous. Hayley, I'm going to be sick. You're going to have to take over a minute.
You're not going to be sick.
Oh, I did two heaves. Honestly, you get down there.
I won't be able to touch that poo.
I'm gonna have to try.
It's human feces. I'm not touching it, Dann. I'm not joking. I mean it. I'm not touching that.
Come on.
Okay, I'll do the outside and then I'm getting out of that toilet. Look at that. Who wants a cup of tea, anyone?
Spin it.
I don't believe in using these. They harbour so many germs. Whoever invented this should be ashamed of themselves.
I think we should just take all of that crap out. And then ask. He ain't gonna keep none of that. Hi. We've just cleaned out the toilet upstairs, and this is some of the stuff that we got out.
These are sundry bits for boxing in those pipes sometime. Anyway, and that's the spare kitchen drawer.
That'll go though, won't it?
Let go in the kitchen.
It's been in the toilet though, John.
I know it was put there just to be out of the way.
And what about this? Can this go in the skip, or do you want to keep
this?
Oh,
no, that's a computer fan.
What are you going to use them for?
Loos usually have fans in them now, don't they?
A little bit of me dies when he says no to everything. We need to really get this house looking amazing for the weekend. Ugh. And he just don't want to throw anything. He needs his ass kicking. Oh, my God, look where he's put that.
Oh! If he's doing that with a cream pot, how much other stuff as we press forward is he going to then be just sneaking on the windowsills out here to bring back in the house?
Failing to get John to part with any of his clutter, Hayley tries a new approach.
I've decided to set up a tarpaulin and I'm going to fill it with recycling stuff. Because if I go for his recycling thing, rather than saying, let's just skip it, he might be a bit more forthcoming in getting rid of things. I can't believe you're going to recycle his bike.
He'll have a purpose for a broken pot, he always does. He's got all these swords. Anybody think he's Zorro?
So, John, the stuff that we've gathered here for you, are you happy to see what you're happy to throw?
So, have a sit down with your dinner tonight or something and just go, right, well,
yeah.
I really don't need 9 badminton rackets and I don't need 12 deck chairs.
Oh, we do need the deck chairs. They're nice.
Really, we're going to get that skip half full.
Of what?
Right, John, well, we're off now. Another day, another room, hopefully another skip.
As the cleaners retreat to their hotel, John is left alone to sift through his recycling pile.
That's an army belt. I wouldn't chuck that out. Well, that's the cut bomb. That can't go.
It's day 3 of the cleanup operation. And so far, progress has been painfully slow.
This is like 1% of the stuff that I'd actually like to throw away. And out of that 1%, he's threw away nothing.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh, I don't know. I'm modest stress.
John, we made a promise.
Oh, yes, so I will take all that away. Doesn't that look better already, doesn't it?
We're hitting just brick walls every corner we turn.
Well, it'll just get
around. He needs to stop holding on for dear life to all of these things. It's like trying to wean a baby off a bottle. He just doesn't want to have it. He won't let go of that tape.
There's the Hoover's damaged, so you can't use it.
So can that be thrown in the skip?
No, absolutely not. It's the best one we've got.
What about this? Because this flip has lost its flop.
Well, you used to be able to buy these separately.
I'll buy you a new flip-flop. It's easier. Just throw it, babe.
What about this?
Well, those are the bouncy things that people had.
That's got a hole in it. Can you put that in the skip, then?
All John has given me to throw is a broken flip-flop and a balloon. I'm half tempted to throw myself in at this stage, just to make it look a bit fuller.
What's the point of having a skip if he's not going to let us fill it? I have to polish your turd, because that's all you can do in this situation.
But there's 2 against 1. I'm overwhelmed. But there's not a lot of stuff I want to get rid of, actually. So I've got this pressure to find somewhere to put it. Yeek. Yeah, now I've got to get this bloody thing tightened up.
To break the cleaning deadlock, Dann and Hayley rework their strategy and decide to continue the clear-out without John.
Right, we've got the perfect opportunity where he's out of the way and we can get rid of some of this crap. See, I just want to throw him.
Throw it in the skip.
There's something living in that. I'm sure I've just watched something jump out of it. I'm worried that as soon as our backs are turned, he's going to be scavenging around here like a mouse. I'm going to use the tarpaulin and just get it covered so it's literally John-proof. No way that he'll get in here.
I am literally buzzing like a hornet because we have filled nearly a whole skip of junk.
I feel like we're finally getting somewhere. Oh, I'm scared. Owls and stuff. You don't get them in Nottingham, do you? Do you know what I mean?
With just 2 days until the homecoming of John's son and heir, Elliot, Dann and Hayley's progress is short-lived.
Oh, my God. That can't go. Oh, no, 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 no. Absolutely not. I mean, this is getting too much. What am I raking around my own stuff out of the bloody skip? Right, I want... Oh, yeah, these... Oh, God. What did they throw out the loo brushes for? Oh, dear. I mean, this is just too much. OK, I've had enough of this.
In northern Scotland, John Ochterlony, 24th Laird of the Gind, has discovered what the cleaners have been up to while his back was turned.
How are you?
Well, I have found a few things in the skip that shouldn't be there. Not passed by me, so I thought I'd just remind you.
What did you fish out the skip, John?
Oh, one little brush. Oh,
stop it. That toilet brush.
Yes.
Oh, John, it harbours so much bacteria. I would feel better if I got you a new one.
Oh, yeah, but it'll still get full of bacteria.
Just don't use it. Have it there for show.
Oh, you have to worry us of this. Where does it all end? Anyway, don't put anything in the skip without showing me.
Okay. I don't know what's happened to the world. That crafty little fox is sneaking out there when I can't see it with my eye. Well, that toilet brush is going back in the skip, and I'm not telling John about it. No way. It's just no way. He's going to end up with salmonella. That's it. Hayley says that's it, so that's it.
In just 2 days' time, John is throwing a party to welcome his son, Elliot, home. But he still isn't getting involved in the clean.
I have no clue where I'm going. Might never come back out.
While Dann concentrates on clearing the hoard of tools from the hallway...
This must be the workshop. Just what I'd expect from John.
Hayley tries to get to the bottom of John's reluctance to throw anything out.
What are those?
Oh, those are old Kinder Egg things.
Oh, they're dusty, John.
Yeah, well, I haven't been up there. I don't know. You can't go and dust. You can dust. Do you want to dust it?
So why have you got them?
I don't know. Elliot used to get them every time we went into the shop.
And you've kept them all this time. Where do you think you got your squirrel tendencies from? What makes you hold on to it all? Like, you know...
Well, just because they're there.
Just because they're there?
Yeah, it's part of the furniture.
Born the son and heir, John spent his childhood years at the Gind. Then, during the Second World War, his father, Tom, was captured by the Nazis, and the Gind was taken over by the Royal Navy. His father eventually returned from the war, and the family moved back in. But the estate never recovered, and John grew up in a house stripped of its former glory.
What did he think about his responsibilities as a laird?
He didn't like it much.
Oh.
Maybe because he was 3.5 years in a prison camp, so I don't know how much that did to him, really.
Did you think that affected him maybe a bit?
Well, he did say once that he would make sure that we never got any pleasure out of this place.
Aww.
Make sure you never enjoy it. What a dreadful thing to say.
Yeah, that's not very kind.
No, it wasn't, especially as my brother and myself were ready to do anything he wanted. But
aww.
He didn't seem,
you know. Do you almost want to prove your father wrong?
Yes, we better try and make it more pleasurable. How do we do that? Got any suggestions?
That's quite a brutal thing to be told that. But, like, I think John's almost, like, emotionless about it. But then the same, like, level, he's got so much, like, emotion for his things. So I don't know whether maybe, like... I don't know whether maybe it's, like, a security thing or I'm not sure, but he seems more emotional about the thought of me throwing his stuff out. And then his dad saying quite a harsh comment to him.
John's father sealed his son's fate by running the Gind into £250,000 worth of debt.
It's a big responsibility, really, all this baggage. So you can see why I walk by a lot of stuff in this house, because somehow they just sod it. You know, I've had enough doing this, I'm going to go and read a book.
With a newfound resolve to rescue the Gind, John and the cleaners finally join forces.
Right, so we're going to start cleaning the side now.
With just 24 hours to go, they need to get the kitchen fit to prepare food for the party.
You don't mind me bleaching the side, do you?
No, not really. Oh, my goodness. Ooh, yeah. It's pretty persistent, though, isn't it?
When was the last time you wiped this surface down?
I don't think I ever have.
Never. Oh, John, look how much better it looks. Oh, I think that's literally an arc de triomphe. I'm so proud of you.
Having finally conquered the kitchen, John is determined to get the cleaners to stay for their last night. To win them round, he's tackling the 10-year-old tide mark on the bathtub.
I'm getting the bath clean for Hayley. We're trying a combination of hot steam, acetone, elbow grease. We ought to try borax, actually.
Wow.
Blimey, John, it stinks in here.
It does a bit, I suspect, yeah.
What are you doing?
Cleaning the bath.
With what?
That's a bit of acetone.
Oh, John, it's burning my lungs.
I am cleaning the bath because Hayley was horrified by it.
I think that with a bit of bleach and a mop...
Yeah?
That'll come up really well, John.
Well, we'll have to take your advice. That'll be the next. Try another set of chemicals.
So you just pour it all around the bath like this. Can you smell how nice that smells?
Yeah.
And then you're just gonna scrub at it and it will remove all of this. Can you see it coming off?
I think it is. We're looking for the magic formula.
Well, you've just found it, my friend.
Well, what about the sideways there? Yeah, we've got... I see the light.
He's so happy in there. He's having a whale of a time swishing that mop around. And I'm happy, and I literally am like in this bleach bubble, floating away onto cloud nine. It's just joyful and triumphant. Can you see how white it's gone? This is the first time that there has been this sparkle of hope that I can see, and that does excite me a little bit.
I suppose you can say I've learned something. So my attitude to cleaning would be certainly modified, perhaps even changed.
If Dann and Hayley are going to stay the night, there is just one last hurdle to overcome.
I feel like I'm in a place now where I can start tackling my bedroom just in preparation for if I stay. I can't stay in it as it is, though.
That's one little sash of the window. There's a cobweb above the door, but these ceilings are about 50 foot high. Yes!
Before they bed down for the night, John extends the hand of traditional Scottish hospitality.
Hi, folks.
Hello.
Are you ready to eat something?
Oh, it's not that placenta, is it?
Haggis.
Oh, I can't eat that, John. Oh, tried you? It and it tastes like bum.
Bum?
You can try and do me a plate and I'll see when it's there. Just do me a small one, though.
Mm, perhaps you should take a seat.
Thank you.
She's looking very suspiciously at that glass.
Yeah, there's all, like, bits on it. Look.
Is there bits on it?
Yeah, look at that one. That bit there. It's all brown at the top.
Well, we can get you another one. That one's never been drunk out of, actually.
Oh, John, there's flies in the bottom of this one.
Oh, dear. Let's try this one.
That's slightly better. Thank you, John.
Bon appetit. There's plenty more where that came from, right?
There's a fly. It's buzzing around me.
Whizzing around?
Look, it's going to land on our food.
There you go. Relax. Oh, you see the nut? Not another one.
Oh, there's nothing everywhere, John. There's another one near you. Yeah. Just get it away, then.
I felt a bit more wine.
Whatever, just fell out of that bottle into your glass.
Probably safe to drink, isn't it? Yes.
God knows how long that moth was rotting in that red wine, but John still, like, drank it.
Just go into the bathroom. Excuse me.
I should have some more wine, I think.
I bet off someone else's plate. I bet with their knife and fork, although I did give him a little bit of a polish when he wasn't looking. And I had drank wine that we discovered a moth in it. But I am proud of myself. I think that I've really achieved something because I would never, ever, ever do that in a million years. Just absolutely not.
With bellies full of haggis and moth-infused wine, Dann and Hayley set about making up their beds for the night.
Oh, come for me.
Hi. To feel a bit safer, I've put my bed in the middle, so I'm away from the spiders then, I feel.
Yes.
OCD-diagnosed Hayley is not taking any chances with her bedding.
I'm just going to put a new mattress on because I don't like the thought of sleeping on someone else's mattress. There we go. Don't take the plastic off.
I'm not going to sleep on that, are you?
I am, because then before I go to bed, I'm going to spray it with some sterilising spray.
This cover should be destroyed, you see. Take it off. It's lovely they're staying, as intended, with your own plastic-covered mattress, for God's sake. It's absolutely insane.
Finally, after 6 hours of preparation, it's bedtime at the Gind.
Just one night. It's literally just one night.
I'm nervous of staying in this house, but I'm never going to feel comfortable, so until I break this cycle of these, like, irrational fears that I have, that's constantly going to be a burden on my life, and I don't want it to be. So I am going to try.
Hi. You all right?
Yeah. You all right?
No, I'm not staying.
Oh, no.
My room is like a dungeon. I want to be able to stay. I've not been able to do it for over 10 years. But I cannot stay in that room. It's driving me up the wall.
He's so transfixed on his surroundings that he cannot possibly tolerate anything else.
It's the final day of the clean, and Hayley has achieved a milestone by managing to stay the night at John's house.
I feel like I should get, like, an award or something because of my OCD, I'm just too scared to, like, do anything like this. But I stayed, and it shows me that if I can do that, I can do, like, other things as well.
But the race is on for the cleaners to get the house ready for the Grand Cayley to celebrate the return of John's son, Elliot, from the US later today.
The future of the Gind is in our hands today. It's kind of, have we done enough to make Elliot think, well, yeah, of course I'm going to keep this in the family? Or is it in the back of his mind where he's just like, I'm just really not that bothered about it?
With just 4 hours until Elliot's arrival, Hayley and Dann get cracking on the finishing touches.
He's had enough as well. Sick of all the dirt.
I think this display is going to be lovely.
After 5 days of hard graft,
that's better.
The skip has finally been filled to the brim with unfinished DIY projects. Flip-flops, mouse droppings, and toilet brushes have all been removed from the house. And with the skip groaning,
some more magazines in there as well.
A recycling van has removed 2 tons of paper, metal, and plastic detritus.
That's it, lads. All right, thanks very much.
With 30-plus guests due to arrive for John's party, for Dann, the devil is in the detail.
I'd love to just put it through the dishwasher if I'm being completely honest.
At home, he redecorates every couple of months, so he's giving John's kitchen a freshen up.
Don't you like to see, like, a dirty pipe turn brilliant white?
Determined to leave no stone unturned on this clean, there's one thing left for Hayley to get her hands on.
Yes?
Come here!
All right.
I'm going to try and see if he'll let me wash his hair, but it is going to have to be behind sterilised plastic gloves. Hello, Poppet.
That was a summons, wasn't it?
And even John's old dressing gown has had the Hayley treatment.
This has actually been boiled within an inch of its life. I'd like you to wear this while I wash your hair.
There. Right.
I'm just getting all the grime out and dislodging it, because no one likes to have a smelly scalp.
Yes.
This will be the cleanest hair you've ever had, I promise you.
Well, this is shampoo all black.
His hair was really, really grubby, and I'd done it, so I think it's a massive step in the right direction. So I'm really proud of myself, and I'm proud of him that he let me do that.
Goodness me, yeah.
But without the approval of Elliot, the heir to the estate, when he arrives back from the US, the last 5 days of backbreaking work will have been for nothing.
I really, really want the gin to be kept within his family, because I know it's what John wants as well. So this is like a huge deal.
I'm shitting bricks for John, if I'm being honest, because I'm just like, I hope we've done enough, I hope we've done enough.
Elliot has only ever known his childhood home to be buried under dust and clutter.
Elliot, oh, how
hi.
Are you?
How are you?
Are you
all right?
Good to see you.
Over the last 20 years, the grand hallway had become John's tool shed, with chainsaws, spanners, and old sandals piled on the floor. Now it's been cleared and its former glory restored. The tools have been removed to the workshop and the freshly scrubbed floor is visible for the first time in years.
Hi, Elliot. Here's a bit of transformation.
Oh,
for
wow.
You.
Hi, are you all right?
Hi,
Dan.
Elliot.
Hello, Hayley.
Elliot, good to meet you.
Do you like it?
I do. It's quite tidy.
It was hard, definitely hard.
Yeah.
Don't look at me like that.
We're looking right at you like that.
The dining room table was littered with paperwork and the floor piled high with decades of recycling. Now the table has been cleared and polished, and the family silver has come out of hiding, proudly on display once more.
Well,
it's so clean. Very impressive.
It looks like proper royal now.
The kitchen was stacked with rubbish. Rotting food littered the work surfaces, and old toys were coated with thick layers of dust. Now the surfaces have been cleared and scrubbed. Elliot's old toys have been bleached, and John has a kitchen fit to cook a haggis in.
Oh my God, where's all the stuff gone? It's very impressive that you guys cleaned this place. It's pretty amazing.
I've got to say, I was really nervous about coming here, obviously, because I do have an illness. So being here has been so good for me, and I can honestly say I would live here.
Really?
Yeah, I would.
Oh,
I really would.
That's a big step forward.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Would you live here, Elliot?
Yeah.
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 That's really nice. It actually looks like Elliot is going to keep on the gind, and I am so happy. Like, literally, I could grow some wings and fly away.
I do feel like I'm bursting with pride, thinking that we've done a really, really good job here and the gind will stay in the family for hopefully another 400 years.
With the transformation complete and the next in line suitably won over, the doors of the gind are flung open to welcome
Hello.
In friends and family. One of the guests is Elliot's aunt, Alison Octolone.
Oh my goodness me, look at that. It's fantastic. It's very tidy and certainly a transformation. What did Elliot think? Did he look at this?
I think he was quite impressed, actually.
I loved the gind because this is where I grew up, and I appreciate the effort that my dad has made. It's definitely nice to have it be in a presentable state. So I would definitely always like to feel like the gind is my home.
After 5 days of obsessively cleaning, their time at the Gind is over for Hayley and Dann.
I've got everything that I need in my life, and the only thing that was holding me back was my obsession to excessively clean. And I honestly think this has taught me a little bit that actually life doesn't revolve around making sure that everything's perfect the whole time. Maybe I have learned that actually I shouldn't really give a shit.
I feel like I've overcome so many phobias of mine. Like, staying over in John's house was huge for me. Like, John lives in grime and dirt and he's not dead. And it's kind of like, I don't need to be so worried and so fearful over everything.
But it's not just the cleaners who have changed their outlook. With Elliot's seal of approval, the family legacy is looking more secure.
I think he was rather impressed by it all, and I found it rather encouraging, because a few times ago he really didn't think it was a good idea, but somehow between then and now he's sort of come around. So I think the future of the Gind is looking more optimistic, and hopefully it'll last for 150 years.
Next time on Obsessive Compulsive Country House Cleaners.
Oh, he's getting ever excited and he's peed on the floor.
Oh, God, it's all coming out. Oh,
there's some quite big lumps of poo, which you could just pick up. These people are not right.